Alright guys, morning! Ohayo, minasan, everyone! Once again, this is Akino Misaki-san from WoWSB Blitz Asia server. Alright, so today I promise you guys that I'll be making a Shmakaze commentary video. So today I'll be making one for it. So now let's get onto it. So right now here we have here is the tier X Imperial Japanese Navy destroyer Shmakaze-san destroyer. So this destroyer possess 15 torpedo tubes 15. So it is displacement of 5 torpedoes and 5 torpedo tubes on mounting on each sections. So the torpedo launchers will be found in the midship part of the destroyer itself. So I will be telling you guys about the ship stats itself, as in the normal and the elite itself. I'll also be explaining the equipment modification for the ship, I mean for the ship itself, and the consumables as well, plus the ship skills itself. So right now let's get on to the stats itself. So for Shmakaze destroyer, her maximum speed is 43 knots for being a stop, 41 for being a is a normal for being a stop as well. And if you fully equip the Shmakaze, or if you bought the equipment, the propulsion equipment, the maximum speed for Shmakaze is 46 knots, and the normal speed for Shmakaze is 43 as well. Only when if you have equipment and got the consumables be equipped. So the steering for Shmakaze is also quite doing well. There's nothing worry about being having a slow maneuvering steering. So Shmakaze is doesn't have any problem related to that. So let's go to the main cannon, the main gun. So the main guns maximum range is 7.96 kilometers, so around light cruiser range already, so it's around 8 clicks. The reloading second is 6 seconds, so it's also nothing average from the American destroyer itself as well. It's the same, but the damage is not quite very effective using AP. So using the high explosive the HE shells is most likely highly recommended. So the torpedoes right now here we have a 610 mm 93 3×5 torpedo right there. So the reloading for the torpedo itself is 74 seconds, equivalent to 75 seconds, which is almost 1 minute already. But that timing is for stock Shmakaze itself, which is there's no equipment, not fully upgraded, and also not fully equipped. So the range is 10.61 kilometers, so you can say it's 10.7 actually. So it's already the range is quite fast. You can really try to sneak attack an enemy battleship and enemy carrier without getting detected itself. So for the torpedo damage is 5,084, because the reason I have this is because let's get on to that later. Okay. For the NTI for the Shmakaze is also quite doing very well. There's nothing more on it. For average range of shooting down is at least 1 to 2. If any enemy bombers are decided to chase you or fighters nearing you, you could at least take down 1 to 2 aircrafts average only. And the consumer is 6.22 kilometers, 6.22 clicks, which is really quite being a very useful against a high tier enemy ship itself. I mean, it's already, let's say it's already very, very nice for the stealth itself. So let's get on to the stacks. For the overall blueprint for these ships, require is 420 blueprints to elite the Shmakaze itself. Because in tier X ship itself, you have a new level, and you have a level 7 6-7s. So you are required 420 orange blueprints, which is for the tier 9 tier 10 ship itself. So let's get on to the torpedoes where I missed just now. Alright, so the reason why I have the 5084 is because for my ship, my elite skills, the ship's elite skills, I choose the torpedo modifications where it increased plus 3% on my torpedo damage and also plus 7% on my torpedo flooding itself. The reason why I choose this is because normally in players, players they will choose torpedo defensive equipment such as the damage control and also the torpedo defensive, where it help to decrease their chances of getting flooded from the torpedo itself. So if I equip with this, the chances of my torpedoes flooding enemy is also slightly increased a little bit, which is better than nothing, I guess. But that's what I do. But if you want, you can choose the plus 5% of the destroyer modifications, which is your Shmakaze could go out to at least 47 knots, I guess. The maximum will be around 48 or 49. But I never choose that, so I'm not really sure. As for the ESP bonus, it's really useless, so you don't need it. And let's get on to the equipment. So for the equipment modifications, I choose the torpedo modifications too, where it minus 5% on my reloading speed and also plus. Because the reason why I choose this is because the Shmakaze reloading, as I say just now, is 74 seconds, right? Is equal to 75, which is around 1 minute plus already in the game. There is a quite disadvantage and also not very constructive towards your gameplay. So if I choose this, my reloading speed for my torpedo now is around 60 seconds, which is much better than before. And for my second equipment, I did not choose the damage control or the steering or the propulsion or the steering modification as well, because I choose the depth protection modification one, where it minus 25% chances of fire being set on my destroyer itself. If any enemy destroyers, ships or the bombers hit me or bomb itself, the chances of me getting fire is also being decreased from their hit itself. The third equipment, I choose the propulsion propulsion modification too, where it plus 5% on my ship's the destroyer speed itself, because for me I like to play not YOLO, I would say like to stick close towards enemy and like to rush as well. So I will choose this instead of the consumer. I used to use this consumer modification one, where it minus 10% on my consumer, so I can bring more stealth than my current 6.22 kilometers range right now. So if I use this, my consumer will be around 5.9 something, I guess. So but without this consumer, your Shmakaze will still be invisible towards enemy itself, because due to what's your consumer is still quite the best. But for this, I choose this because so my ship can chase up to the enemy cruiser or the battleship itself. So I have no worries about getting being hit itself. And also the other major factors is capturing base, because I like to, not say I like to capture base, but it's due to the time factors and the points itself. So the timing is the factor, so I like to go fast, so I will choose this instead. So if there's nothing else, let's go for some games and I will tell you the tips and tricks and the advice for being an effective Shmakaze. Right, so right now we are in the battle, not in the battle, I mean queuing up in a match, in matchmaking. So in the matchmaking we have 9 destroyers, 19 cruisers, 12 battleships and 4 aircraft carriers. So if I am right, we will be seeing enemy ship itself, I guess, since there's a tier 9 right there. So how long did it take for me to elite my Shmakaze? It took me around 1,000 battles, 1,100 to 1,200 estimate battles to elite my Shmakaze due to need to green the blueprints, the orange blueprints, because the orange blueprints are very rare to get. Yeah, there's enemy cruiser there. Yep. Yeah, because the orange blueprints are very hard to get. It's very rare, as the chances of getting is like 1 upon 10, I guess. Not 1 upon 10, around 5 upon 10. Like out of the 10 battles, I only get 5 or 2 or 6 within of my 10 battles itself. So it took me around 1,100 to 1,200 estimate battles to elite my Shmakaze. Yeah, it was a very tough green. And I don't like to use gold and money to spend on my crates or the continent itself, because I prefer grinding rather than spending money. And now we are in a battle right now in the map encounter, and we have an enemy tier 9 cruiser right there from the Brave Fleet, and his name is Dicky. That's a very weird name. Right, so we have an enemy gearing right there, engaging it, and we miss. No. Alright, so the enemy DK is right there. So I might hit that Shima. They're gearing. Alright, so they're gearing down. Mm-hmm. Oh my, what the heck? So right now there's a cruiser right there. He's keep me waiting for him. Come on, boy. To seal up. Yes. Nice. So the DK is right there, and he should be coming for me instead. Right, the enemy cruiser is down. So right now let's turn right, hard right, hard to starboard side, and full speed running away. Whew. No. Okay, the enemy ships are in me, the boats, the Ibuki. So I'm gonna attack this guy. Yep. So apparently the guy is coming, so I'm going to move out. Ding is coming out actually. Yep, he's playing off. So, 3 torpedoes is on that DP guy. Holy shit! There's a freaking Ibuki there! Alright, let's turn to the left side. Okay, let's take a torpedo to... Oh my god. I think I have them. Oh my god. Let's run. Oh my god, 16 HP, seriously bro. Oh my! I must survive, actually. Well guys, that was a mistake guys. I'm so sorry, that was a mistake. Yeah, that was a very terrible mistake. So apparently the guy Dicky is... Yeah, he's not there though. Let's see. Yeah, I need to play on cautions. I'm left on 1000 HP left. And my next preparing consumable is 51 seconds. That is very, very bad. Come on, guns. Come on. Guy. So we have 3 enemy cruisers on my port side, which is near the enemy base spawn itself. So I guess I will need to repair first. Oh, right there, there's one already. Because due to my HP, so I cannot go near to enemy, so I will just use long range torpedo tube instead. Long range torpedo should hit the enemy itself. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, so that is very bad. Not a single flooding. So I flood the enemy itself. On fire, I think that cruiser is dead. Now I just need to survive. Yep. The enemy cruiser is down, so left 20 seconds and we win the game. Not sure where that geeky guy went. 10 seconds, 9, 8, yeah, we won. Alright, there we go, we won. Alright, so now let's explain how many torpedoes need for certain ships. Alright, so if you are the stock Shmakaze, just mean you just freshly buy the Shmakaze itself and without any upgrading or equipment. If you want to engage a tier 9 and tier 10 destroyer, the fact is using 5 torpedoes are enough, but highly suggest that you use the guns first to take out at least a quarter damage of the enemy destroyer itself, HP, the health points. And then you just launch the 5 torpedoes towards the enemy and then sink the enemy itself. And if you are engaging an enemy destroyer in the elite itself, just use 5 torpedoes same again, and then yeah, if possible use guns and take out a quarter HP of the enemy. Yeah, the same thing. But if you are engaging the cruiser, a heavy cruiser, CA heavy cruiser, as in Zhao, Moskva, Hindenburg, or the Des Moines itself, if you are stock Shmakaze, 10 torpedo tubes might be enough. No, might not be enough, so you need 15 at least. But the best choice is always use your guns to take out at least a quarter HP and then send your torpedoes. But if you are elite, 10 torpedoes will be enough actually, 10 torpedoes. But still, try to use your guns and take out a quarter HP of it. And if you are engaging a battleship using a stock Shmakaze, like Iowa and Izumo, but if you are stock Shmakaze, the chances for you sinking an enemy battleship is not very highly possible, so use 15 torpedoes instead of 10. But if you are elite, right, the chances of you sinking an enemy battleship is yes possible, but you will need to use your main guns to take out a quarter of at least half a HP of the enemy ship health point itself, the HP, and then you just send 10 torpedoes out and then sink enemy itself. As for the enemy aircraft carrier, you can either use if you are a certain player that like to play long range, 15 will be a best choice. But if you're the person who like to play close range, 10 will do actually. 10. Regardless, normal or elite. But if you are VSing a player aircraft carrier, the best answer to you is use launch everything 15 torpedoes towards the enemy itself. And same as for enemy cruisers and battleship. As for destroyer, try to just launch 10, don't launch 15 to waste your torpedoes, because reloading of the torpedo is taking my own sweet time. So right now we're in the same again encounter. We have a 3. So this is a cruiser and destroyer match again. So let's see, there's a Shmakaze right there. Right now you'll see what I mean by 5 torpedoes. Oh right, there's 2 actually. 2 Shmakaze. So we'll try to sink one first.
Yeah, I feel. So let's try to sink it. Yep. Alright, so there's an enemy. That's my, is it that's my? Come on, turn left, move left. Go straight. Yeah, that's a death mark. Oh my god, this hurts. Jesus Christ. Wow, they are very Oh! 2000 left. Save me, boys. Come on. Save me, Zhao. Oh my god. Yeah, I'm down. Every time with destroyers and cruisers, I always down. I have no idea why. Well, I think I'll win the game. Okay. Consider the enemy that's more is dying, things are on fire, and yeah. Yeah, there we go. So, I think that's how we play the game itself. So I already explained already, so let's wait for my game to finish. Okay, alright, so let's explain on my Shmakaze profile. Alright, so my profile, my Shmakaze is the average damage for my Shmakaze is 100,000 damage, 100,006. Normally in Asia server you won't see any people do such tremendously high damage itself, because I'm not sure why, but most of them I only see like 70,000 to 80,000 and 90,000, that's all. There's no 100,000. But the if you can see in the top damage itself on the destroyer, like this guy from the Ghost Fleet, this NG guy, his Shmakaze profile also not, it's just 70,000. Play around also same, almost the same battles as amount the same battle better than me, but it's just 70,000. This guy also not a good destroyer player, so I played with him before, he doesn't really works well. And Spy Draco, no, I don't think he have. Yep, he don't have. So all that also one of my friend, but he's not a good player also, but just an average guy who play destroyer itself. And 70,000 damage also, 70,000 damage, and this Dr. Posh also another fella, but not a good guy also. Just started to play Japanese destroyer, but playing before he really can't do quite well also. And we also have another from the Arma Fleet, which is the Warp 281, but he does 90,000 damage, but just because he only plays 600 new battles. Well, I never seen online before, so I'm not sure. But there's a couple from the Korea Fleet, which is ER1 guy. They also have Shmakaze, but never play very quite well. Then there's also a couple from the Fox Fleet also, but they also have Shmakaze, but they also cannot play quite well. We also have one for WWMY Fleet. They also can't play well, and yeah. Like this guy top tier also. Let's check his Shmakaze. And you will see Shmakaze right here, 71% and 16,000 damage. You see, this guy have how many battles? Yep, not a good player. Also, and Trin Hassan don't even have Shmakaze, right? Yeah, he don't have. So yep, still waiting for it. So apparently the Asia server chat is having some very very funny conversations. Let's check on the conversations. Tata, are you okay, friendly? Baba. So let's check on their conversation. Anybody join teammate? Eat my memes. If I buy. This guy, I'm sure I know who is he. He's a Facebook, so yeah, he's being recorded. So I need her to help me put blah, 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 blah. Why? And this guy is surely getting being famous on it. And hey, I think you finish. Okay, we won. Alright, good job. We won the game. Alright, so apparently the previous battle I also F up the sequence itself, where I shouldn't lean near to the rock itself, and yep, I got ambushed by the cruisers, the enemy cruisers. Heavy cruisers. So I already explained the equipments, the modifications, the consumables to equip, and also the amount of torpedoes to sunk each specific ship cluster itself. Yep. So what should I explain? Ah yes, using Shmakaze, the tips. Alright, so for Shmakaze, if you see someone that already launched torpedo at you, as in if you see an enemy player and is approaching to you, right? But what I'm talking about is broadside to broadside, which is you are showing your broadside towards the enemy and enemy showing broadside towards you, but both of you are sailing straight line. And if you happen to hear some torpedo splash sounds, or if you happen to see the enemy the enemy destroyer suddenly turn right or turn left, chances of that enemy dropping a torpedo is already on 75%. So once, if you see that is happening, or if you see the enemy destroyer already spotted you, straight away turn away. Don't hesitate. Just turn away. The enemy Shmakaze facing you right now, right? Just turn to left or right to dodge the torpedoes. But because you won't know that the enemy already dropped the torpedoes and is heading towards you. That's part of the tactics on it, dodging enemy torpedoes. And the other one will be enemy sneaking attack, where try not to stick so close towards enemy before you use a speed boost and rush the enemy and fire a salvo torpedoes and sink the target itself. That's also not part of tactics. Another one will be using HE shells to fire on the enemy ships and set he or she on fire first, then use your torpedoes and try to aim the target itself. Right now, we're aiming out right there. So I will try to sing the Yamakura there, and then the outright and the Yamakura there. So apparently the Awa is sitting down right there, I'm not sure why. So I sent 10 torpedoes and hit on the Yamato right there, good job. And now reverse, and then we will use our shells to hit the enemy right there, Yamato. And he's on flooding. He's mine. Oh my god. Alright, so we'll go and bravo and find the enemy right there. So I have 30 seconds and 26 seconds on my video. Seriously, that bomber? Seriously, bro. Okay. Speed boost. Using my enemy, using my protections. So let's see that fella, is it turning right? Yes, he's turning right. That's a good one. So now I'll be just, since that fella HP is around half already, reaching half, I will just launch 10 torpedo tubes and see how this goes. Maybe it will hit. Okay, this will hit on 4. And yes, he's down. And on the enemy, I wipe out. So right now we have the the enemy carrier I will be carrying, since already there's two battleship and one cruisers right there. So I'll be using spread mode for this. So if that destroyer suddenly turn right and they'll be hitting itself. Alright, there's a enemy cruiser and enemy destroyers on my top on alpha side. That fella is not even bothered to turn right. that is playing left. Right, okay, so he's not bothering on me. So there's an enemy, what is it? Baltimore right there. Tier 9 heavy cruiser, American. So, 5 ready. Bye bye. And let's head for north and find the destroyer. If I find there's one destroyer. Where is the destroyer? There should be one destroyer right here. But I can't find it. Yeah, can't find this Shmakaze. Ah, right there. Yeah, right there. So I just use my guns currently. And I can left right the one. If I want to. Come on. Torpedo? Gun. Torpedo? Oh gun. Torpedo gun. Yeah, torpedo do. No! Ah. Right, so that's another Bravo Zulu gameplay, a good one. Yep, another good gameplay. So let's go for another one. Interesting. 3 tiers and 5 tier 9. Interesting. Oh, now 4 only. Just now that was the Alva guy. So I already explained the equipment, the consumables, and the tips and the tricks itself also. And for Shmakaze, please try really not to go and solo enemy play itself if you're really incapable of it, unless you are you know what you're doing and yeah, you're fine. Like me, I know I'm doing so, yeah. But sometimes I always like lose to boats itself due to their super power. They have this super power. They could like turn 360 180 suddenly in the middle of the in the map, or suddenly they will stop itself and my torpedoes all miss. If not, they will chase me from point A to point C for no reason, where there's like my team ally ship is just beside them, but they will just chase me down from point to point C with a laser accuracy. And the enemy aircraft carrier, they also very funny. They will just send bombers to instead to your team ally, battleships and cruisers. Such funny. Hate boats, but no choice. So apparently it's now it's past a minute already, and it's almost reaching 2 minutes, and we are not in the battle yet. Guess this will be interesting. Let's see. Wow, this will be interesting game, guys. Okay, so you'll be facing two enemy. One is Yugumo player and one is the Iowa. Okay, so I have a Yugumo ally on my team, but I can't expect much from him. I don't know. I never know this guy. But that guy Spy Draco, I know him before. Quite also an average destroyer player. But not so good, but just an average. As for the guy, the Vice Admiral Miko, played him before, man before. I would say he also not a good, not a pro, but just an average player. So right now I spawn in the SMRA, it's the same map, encounter map again. And I guess I will go right side and left side, and then we take out the enemy destroyer and the cruisers right there. you will often see either one enemy destroyers or two enemy cruisers spawning on the left side. If not, if it's all our battleship, you will see two battleships coming on the left side. But right now, we see the ROI is right there. There we go, the enemy Ibuki right there. So there apparently there's no enemy destroyers right here. So I launch 10 ready, time to run off. The enemy Ibuki is down. There's an enemy Yugumo right there. Yep, the Yugumo's right there. So where is my friend? Oh, he's right there. So I'll go for the Yugumo right there. Showing trick to us. Good one. Wow, this hurts. So I got him. I think that LY is coming for me instead. That's very funny. So the Awa is I will save it for later. Right now I'm just focusing on so I hit 2-1 towards him. I bet the ROI didn't realize that I'm gonna come for him actually. But camping behind an island with a battleship is really a bit bad idea, bro. You shouldn't do that. And you're getting ambushed, bro. Yep. There's the ROI there, reversing. Oh, too bad, your gun is not going to do something to me. There we go. Took out the Alva already. Now the enemy carrier is right there and the cruiser is right there. So I will personally take out the cruiser first. Apparently my friend took out the enemy battleship. Good one. So the enemy aircraft crash are there, so yep, and great enemy engaging me again. Set that enemy carry on fire. Right now, let's go for the freaking destroyer. Irritating as hell. Let's see if he could get him or I could get him. He missed. He missed. And taken on his kills. That was a good game. The Awa shouldn't camp at that island behind, but yep. Yeah, I think this is last game for me, then I think that's all for me. Yep. That's all for me, I guess. If nothing else, I wish you all the best towards all your future gameplay, guys, and also good luck in the Corsi event. Hope you all already get what you wanted. And yeah, if there's nothing else, remember to like and subscribe to me. And yeah, that's all for me.